Lesson 3-4, boys and girls, using formulas. And in this lesson, you'll solve problems by using formulas. Let's take a look at the application in travel. You slide behind the wheel of a red convertible. The engine roars as you squeal away down the road. With the top down, the sound of the whipping wind drowns out the world until suddenly the engine stops. Just how far back was that gas station? Wish I could have figured the gas mileage on this thing before I left home. Well, you can use a formula to compute gas mileage, okay? So in this case, we will be using formulas to be able to solve problems. And let's learn the concept. First thing we need to know is we need to know what the formula is. A formula shows the relationship among certain quantities. The formula below can be used to find the miles per gallon achieved by a car. So if you look at this formula right here, you have the number of miles driven, which is in M, okay, divided by number of gallons of gas. There's an S there somewhere, right there, equals miles per gallon, mpg. Okay, so M divided by G equals mpg. That is a formula that we will use, okay, to be able to find or to compute for gas mileage. Okay, and let's take a look at example one. You drove 192.8 miles before your convertible ran out of gas. Okay, the gas hold tanks. The gas tank holds 11 gallons and was full. In your left. What gas mileage does the car get? Okay. Again, using our formula, which is M divided by G equals miles per gallon, we substitute 192.82 M and 11 capacity of the tank, 11 gallons. Okay. And that should give us, using our calculator, 17.527272. Okay. Estimate 20 divided by 10, and it should be around 20, and this is close enough to 20. So the car gets about 17.5 miles per gallon. Okay, let's take a look at another formula. There are formulas associated for almost every field of study. Okay. Example 2 is the formula of geometry. A pentagon is a polygon with 5 sides. In a regular pentagon, all of the sides are the same length and all the angles have the same measure. The area A of a regular pentagon can be found by using the formula A equals 5 halves SA, where S is the length of the side of the pentagon and A is the length of the aquifer. Okay? Find the area of the pentagon shown at the right. So you are given this formula, A equals 5 halves SA. S represents the side, and A represents the apothem of the pentagon. Don't worry about that. We don't need to know the meaning for now. Okay, so just concentrate on what the formula is. And the formula given will be S, sorry, not that one, this one. S equals 5 halves SA. Okay, substitute the value of S, which is 9, and 6.248. Okay, now we have 139.55 halves times 9 times 6.2 will give us 139.5. So the area of the pentagon is 139.5 square inches. Okay? It's an easy lesson. And therefore, when you're done, okay, on Google Forms or my big canvas, okay, type a summary of what you've learned by responding to the objectives of the lesson. Type a question you might want to ask in class about this lesson. Thank you.